Well, hello, everybody, and welcome to La Fonteta in Valencia, Spain. This is the EuroLeague Women quarterfinals, game two, and the game between Valencia Basket and Beretta Famalicchio. You can see there at the bottom, game one finished 75-63. Also, the other quarterfinal openers, and it was a very competitive first game between these two teams. And you also can see today the action that is taking place. Avenida and Prague will be tipping off later tonight, as will Bourges and Mersin. And you can see Fenerbahce and Sopron in Hungary already underway. So Valencia without Alba Torrens, without Cristina Uvinha, and of course the January departure really out for most of the season, all the season, Beck Allen, the Australian international who got injured during the World Cup. Somehow, some way, they've had a very impressive EuroLeague women campaign. And it was much, I think, to the surprise of a lot of people that they were able to be as competitive as they were in game one. The game was knotted with 5 minutes remaining, and the points just dried up. And of course, Scio, just a very talented Scio team with Marina Mabry. Also, Astudu made a lot of big baskets. Ivor Matejic, Mikel Maniste, amongst the referees for tonight's game. Also, Anastasios Kardaris. So, the referees from Czech Republic, Estonia, and Greece. And here are the Scio players warming, stretching, getting ready for tonight's game here. And Valencia, well, this place is pretty crazy if you come to Valencia right now because of all of the festivities going on with Las Fallas, the annual celebration in the city. It is 24/7 fireworks on every street corner and marching bands and a very loud festive atmosphere. So lots of fireworks outside, and the question will be, what type of fireworks are we going to see inside tonight? You know that Scio do not want this to go to a third game. They want to take care of business tonight and start thinking about playing in the Final Four. Meanwhile, Valencia, they have to draw encouragement from the way they played in game one and probably feel like that was a game they could have won, the way they competed and the way they kept it close for pretty much the entire game until the last couple of minutes when it was apparent that they weren't going to win the basketball game. But again, they played without some very important pieces to the puzzle, and they coped well. So Scio are under no illusion as to the task ahead for them. Of course, their home has been a fortress all season where they just continue to win, win, win. Nobody's beating them, and playing on the road could be a little bit different with this hostile atmosphere. So the lights lowering in this famous La Fonteta. And folks, if you ever come to Valencia, you want to come see this arena, but also the entire El Alcoria complex. It probably ranks number one in Europe in terms of facilities for basketball. It is a remarkable, remarkable place. And it just goes to show you how much emphasis, how much of a connection they have with the sport of basketball. And this is also where, don't forget, the last FIBA Women's Eurobasket final phase was staged when Serbia beat France in that thrilling final. So here we are again, and the Valencia players, fans getting a look at some of the sights and the sounds from the past. It is a really good crowd, a good basketball supporting public here. They also have a men's team, Valencia Basket, and they all operate under the same club, which is it's nice to see. So Valencia Basket, again, Scio have already come out And as Valencia does come out, go ahead and mention to you some of the numbers. Well, Cox, their highest-rated efficiency player. There's Alba Torrens is going to play tonight, as well as Christina Uvinha. Coach Burgos saying yesterday, well, you know what, a couple of days ago, we're going to wait and see how they are by the end of their test, and we'll see how they're feeling. But clearly they're not going to get in if they're not in the game rhythm. So just the sight of them, I think, will give these players and this crowd an emotional lift. There's been no more exciting player, in my opinion, in European women's basketball for the last 15 years than Alba Torrens. And now as she hits that perhaps final third of her career, she would like to bring a title here to Valencia Basket. And she's definitely had her share of injuries where she has played over the years. And don't forget, she was the EuroLeague Women Final Four MVP. As you see, Coach Burgos and Coach Dikoulakis meeting at midcourt. Dikoulakis from Greece, Coach Burgos from here in Spain. And Alba Torrens not able to play in that last Eurobasket women, and that proved costly. She got hurt, wasn't able to go. You can see Quero Casas, Leticia Romero, Raquel Carrera, Lauren Cox, and Cassidy Burdick in the starting five, with Torrens, Uvinha, Elena Buenavida, Angela Salvadores amongst all of the players coming off the bench tonight. And there's Ruben Burgos. Hey, it's a series. You know, they were competitive in the first game, and we'll be looking for more of the same tonight. It'll be Marina Mabry, Constanza Verano, Ryan Howard, Jasmine Keys, and Astudu, who's a Spain international. These fans will know very well. And then Kim Mestag, Georgia Santana, amongst the players coming off the bench today for this Skio team. So even some of the fans dressed up in the Fias attire, the women as they dress up and they fix their hair a special way, but also wear these very big dresses, beautiful dresses. They're called falleras, and the men that dress up, they're called falleros. And I dare say that those people that we just saw in the stands, they will be hitting the streets after these games for a night of revelry and walking around town. Because again, this is Las Fallas in the city of Valencia, a very popular city of Valencia. There you see some falleras in the crowd there with the hair fixed up. But they want to see a win tonight, and they want to know that their team is going to be going back to Italy for a game three. And if that game three is going to be played, it's going to be on March 22nd. There's another Fayetta right in the middle there with her hair all fixed up. So wearing the Las Fallas top. So a lot of anticipation before this game. Valencia, again, so much adversity they've had to overcome this season with respect to injuries and losing Beck Allen to the broken ribs that she suffered while playing for Australia and helping them clinch third place at the FIBA Women's Basketball World Cup. But also the injuries of late. There's George Dikoulakis. Of course, he came onto the scene. He's coached numerous clubs, but came onto the scene. You go back to FIBA Women's Eurobasket 2009 when he was an assistant coach to Greece, to Kostas Missis. And since that point, he has just moved on to various clubs and opportunities, national teams, and clearly one of the great coaches in this competition. Of course, I think he'd like to underline that, put an exclamation mark behind his name with a title. this season. Six of their previous eight games before this one in the EuroLeague Women, trying to get back to winning ways tonight against a very good Skio. We're underway in La Fonteta, Valencia, folks. Welcomes the EuroLeague Women quarterfinals. It's game two, Skio with a 1-0 lead. May feel like they're within touching distance of the final four, but they're going to have to be good. Oh, very rare turnover. Querol Casas, it took so long without making a pass that she forgot she had already dribbled. So she was whistled for a double dribble. Another of the Spain internationals in this team. Here's Mabry. And Mabry goes in, misses her first attempt. Putting the basketball on the deck and driving to the basket and missing the Spain international, Raquel Carrera. Now quickly, the skip pass over to Mabry. She does a good job making the catch and passing it back. Ryan Howard. There's Verona dribbling off her foot. She gets it back. She dumps it down low. Astudu. That was a mistake. Lauren Cox can't give away a layup, letting him throw over the defense. Casas. Taking on Mabry, brings it back out. Shot clock winding down. Carrera hands it off. And a nice pass in the end. And they get the layup. Great patience. And it looked like Skio played defense for about 22 seconds there. And that last 2 seconds hurt their chances. Howard, where's the white headband? Mabry gets in the paint. Nice handoff to Keys. And Keys will go to the free throw line. So that foul, Cassidy Burdick, who has only played 3 EuroLeague women games, joining this team late, averaging 5.7 points per game. Keys goes to the line and makes the first. The Italy international played in this very arena at the FIBA Women's Eurobasket. So she makes both free throws, and the free throw shooting so important, as Valencia will tell you, because in that first meeting, they shot in the 50s. Skio also struggled from the line, but they were much better than that. Here is Cox, left open for three, and she nails the jump shot. Valencia, you can feel they're charged up from this crowd. Here's Mabry, goes behind the back, gets inside, and she earns a trip to the line. Casas just walks away. She reached in. She thinks she got all ball there, but here is Mabry, who really is just an amazing player to watch. You'll see that she's got skill. Not evident on that free throw. She plays with a lot of fire, and she loves to engage in those one-on-one battles, both on the court in terms of competition, but also verbal You don't want to have a conversation with her. It's only going to make her play better. Here's Casas. Cox to Burdick. Passes back into the paint, and Burdick looked like she elected not to try to get the ball right there at the end. And you can see the Valencia making the commitment to try to get the basketball inside. Here's Cox. Okay, well, she's open, and she hit 1-3 earlier. Now the foul on Verona. That's a good name for an Italian player. Constanza Verona. Well, that was a pass that somehow Valencia got away with, and it might create an opportunity here, but Carrera has the ball knocked away. She kind of fell asleep. She has to feel the defender on her, know that she's close by. Has to do, fouled, nope, traveled. Cassidy Burdick. Has to play some important minutes here. Here's Romero for three. Gets it to go. And here's Burdick, native of Charlotte, North Carolina, my hometown. Brings it back outside. Now, Romero, another one, this time a little long. Interesting that Burdick was able to escape the, or get out of the state of North Carolina without going to college there. Instead, she went to Tennessee, which traditionally one of the powerhouses of the women's game. Raquel Carrera brings it back out. And the basketball. Refs are going to put their heads together to find out where it should go. And it looks like it's going to be awarded to Schio. It looks like Verona maybe got away with some hand checking there. Valencia fans like to have a good time. They like to shout at the referees. All in good fun. Here is the great anticipation and the steal by Carrera. So Raquel Carrera getting it to drop. Mabry, quick pass down low to Keys. Such an intelligent player. Good move by Schio. Shot clock ticking down. Burdick has to lean in, and she doesn't get it off in time. Burdick played almost 20 minutes in game one, but only took one shot. Here's a drive in the basket. Good by Verona to close the gap back to 1 point. Nice no look and down low, and Carrera again gets it to drop. He's got 4 points. Raquel Carrera only had 5 points in game one. She was 2-7 from the floor, but this is a problem. Burgos needs to reset the defense here because Skia are just throwing over the top and getting those layups. Casas, front and back, stays out. Mabry brings it up. Has to do. Quick pass, and again, Carrera, and she is fouled by Mabry. Yeah, that was a good call. So Mabry comes out. Something about the rotational defense. I wasn't exactly sure what he was saying, but here's Carrera. So that's a big plus to get Mabry out of the game because she causes so many problems with her versatility. And Carrera, meanwhile, makes both free throws. And it's really not clear at this point how much, if at all, Alba Torrens and Christina Uvinia are going to play tonight. I noticed that Mabry did stay in the game. Excuse me. Takes the shot, misses. Burdick hands it off to Salvadores. Angela Salvadores spins, gets down the baseline, and puts it up. Great move, but a million-dollar move. 5 cent finish. Howard for three, and Skio tie the game. Romero throws it in to Cox, and she gets swatted by Astudu. Now quickly to Keys, who's just getting layup attempt after layup attempt, but this time she misses. Well, Dick Lacas' team is getting a lot of good looks, as is Valencia. Carrera, she's got 6 points. Or no, make it eight. She is having a great first quarter already. In the first 8 minutes of this game, has scored more points than she had in game one when she had five. Verona pulls up right at the stripe. And she is fouled by Romero. Could be Cox. It is Romero indeed, her second foul. So that's going to bring, okay, Mabry is going out of the game now. So Kim Mestag, one of the premier sharpshooters in Europe, comes into the game, the Belgium international. And also coming in for Valencia is Laia Lamana and Marie Gulich. She only makes one of two, Verona, so Skia is still trailing by a point. Carrera, terrific take, and she is fouled on the drive by Pestagno. The Italy internationals just come into the game. Boy, Carrera is just really leading this team tonight. Just a little too much contact there by Pestagno. to the referee's liking, and Raquel Carrera misses. So she remains stuck on 10 points. Georgia Satana's into the game as well. Handling the basketball, passes over to Howard. Bastagno, the fake, drives in and scores. Well, that's the best way to answer a foul, to go down and score. Salvador is missing. And now the foul on Astudu. So a break for Valencia. Good hustle into the corner by Burdick to get the basketball. So the crowd showing the love to Carrera, who was terrific in this first quarter, leading the team with 10 points. Elena Buenavides checked into the game. And Burdick tried to get the ball to Gulich. 11 on the shot clock. Launching it and missing Gulich, but again, the hustle this time. Lamana not able to get it. Basketball goes over to Schio. An offensive foul called on Howard. Svinteraitė, the Lithuanian, Egle Svinteraitė in the game. So it was Howard that was called for the push on Lamana. 6 second difference on the game clock and the shot clock. Here's Gulich. She's going to town. Tries to pass it back outside and not on the same page as Buenavida. So Gulich whistled for the personal. Oh, Svinteraitė gets the shot off right in the nick of time to put Schio back on top. What a great first quarter that was. One quarter in the books. And Schio leading it 19-18 over Valencia. Game two of the quarterfinals. Those are the leaders. Keys getting a lot of layups as well as Carrera. So very even.
Venga, que quiera poner,
So Pereira's going to check back into the game for Valencia. And Gulic, who really played well for Germany in their qualifying games for the FIBA Women's Eurobasket and helped them qualify for the tournament that's going to be in Israel and Slovenia. She remains in the game. Skiotto starting with possession. And a little bit of illegal contact has been called on Valencia. Alba Turin's also checked into the game, so keep an eye on her for Valencia. See how she gets around on that leg, her knee, which she sprained about a month and a half ago. She wears number 3. Here is also checking in Elisa Pena. And the former Wake Forest University star turns it over. Now pulling up and missing with her first attempt. Torrens, however, Buena Vida with the rebound. So Torrens puts up another, and this time, born to thrill, Alba Torrens makes it. Another pass down low, and this time, Mestag's attempt goes in and out. So Valencia a little fortunate. A little slow in transition defense. How about Romero? Her second bucket of the game. She's got 5 points. Mestag, you can't leave her open. She is within her shooting range when she walks into the gym, not even on the court. She can make it from anywhere. You got to have a hand in the face. Gulic for 3. Good. She gets it right back. And she was fouled on the play. A chance for a 4-point play. Wow. Romari comes in, averaging 9 points, 4.7 rebounds, 1.6 assists. And what everybody will know is that she's a very good 3-point shooter, 8 of 11. A 16 of 30 coming into this game. So better than 50%. And that's what you call a weapon. And she does indeed have the game's first 4-point play. And stretches the advantage to 27-22, Valencia's biggest of the contest. Another near miss. Now Carrera answers the other way. Romero skip pass. Gulic posting up, and she is fouled by Pena. Well, it looks like there's going to be a new champion in the EuroLeague Women with Sopran losing tonight. Meanwhile, Carrera just keeps on keeping on. Another layup for her and Valencia. Right now, with the wind in their sails, George Dikalakis calls timeout for Skio. His team down 29-22. Thank you. Skio also wearing the orange, inbound the basketball tonight. And bring it across midcourt. Kim Mestag, a little sloppy with the ball handling. Now the pass goes right at her feet from Svintarite. Then the ball knocked away. The Valencia defense swarming, forces a turnover. Romero on the break, bumped by Satana, and the foul has been called. And you can see the Valencia really want to ratchet up the tempo. They want to get it going quickly where Romero can get out and use her fast breaking skills. Now Satana thinks she got all ball, and she might have. But at the end of the day, she really swung down hard on the ball from up high. And when the referee sees that, he's thinking, has she just committed the foul? There's Romero. Had a real interesting career. Talk about highs and lows, and it feels like she's kind of trending in the right direction right now. She's at the free throw line, taking her time and making both free throws. The biggest lead grows to 9 for either team. Mabry backing up. Nowhere to go. Buena Vida playing great D. Oh, boy, that is just a quality player right there to make that shot. I mean, they could quite easily have called a foul on Buena Vida. It looked like she was chest bumping her. Torrens, the dump. One pass too many, no. Romero gets it. Well, maybe one pass too many. But Valencia working for the easy shot sometimes. That's the second time in the game where it's just taken a little too long. But you can see with Coach Burgos, how he really emphasizes a game predicated on movement, on speed, on making the extra pass, making that defense work. And it's one reason why, even with Uvinia and Torrens not available last week, this Valencia team was competitive and almost pulled a surprise. Astudu back in the game. Here's Mabry. Verona from outside. She hits a 3. Boy, she has some big shots in her arsenal. Casas also back in the game, gets it over to Torrens. Gulic, turnaround in the paint. What a soft touch that. She's like a machine right now, boy. She is feeling it. Back up to 6-point advantage. Well, great recovery by the defense. Not sure why Kim Mestag thought she was going to be able to make that pass. And Casas, she drives in, and the foul has been called. And the difference there is that Casas put the ball up and in, and the Fayettas are celebrating in the stands. The other end, Mestag drove all the way in and then passed it back, tried to make a pass back out. And Torrens, she doesn't just give them an emotional lift with her presence. She came out and played very well. And Casas goes to 5 points. And the Taronja crowd excited tonight as their team goes back up by 9. Here's Mabry. Oh, little hesitation. Out to Keys. Mestag gets it to Keys, but she doesn't catch it. And picking it up and running is Salvadores. She passes to the corner. Casas for 3. Astudu goes to work on Carrera. She gets blocked, though. Good recovery from Raquel Carrera. Well, the bigs for Valencia tonight have been outstanding. Nice little runner. And the follow, nobody boxes out. Verona was just guilty of ball watching. She needed to find Casas to box her out. She did not. And they paid the price. And now Verona's chirping at the referee about something. She needs to get over to the bench, start learning to box out. Timeout, 38-27. George Zikalakis really challenging his team, really questioning the heart, saying it's not there. They're being out-hustled, out-worked right now by Valencia. It's a rare sight to see Zikalakis really tear into his team, but he just did. So Verona, up high, gets it to Howard. And the quickest way that we'll see what type of impact that has, and another turnover. Not sure what happened. Keys didn't think that was for her. It was a little high maybe from Howard. We'll see how they do in terms of rebounding, if the effort is going to be where it needs to be. Obviously on defense as well. Salvadores gets past Mabry, puts up a tough shot. She can't be looking for the referee to bail her out on calls. She's got to make the right play, and Howard goes the other end. That is a very bad sequence from Salvadores. Not only does she miss the shot, instead of getting back on defense, she's complaining, and Howard strokes the jumper. Oh, boy, a telegraph pass by Romero, read beautifully by Mabry, who spins, gets in. She gets swatted by Carrera. Oh, and almost a travel. Boy, she was lucky the whistle didn't blow on that. Carrera has just been tremendous tonight. Casas gets the baseline, tries to get it to Cox. And Howard recovers just in time, 4.2 seconds on the shot clock. And now Gulich, who has been playing well, is actually going to come back in for Cox. So 4.2 seconds and on the shot clock, so Burgos wants to talk about it, make sure they get a good attempt off, a good shot. So 4.2 seconds left. And Romero needs to get it in. She does, just in time to Carrera. And they got a good look from Cox. So Cox stayed in the game. I thought Gulich was coming back in, but that was just for the timeout. Keys, they leave her open and they pay the price. Well, she might just be their best player tonight, the way that she has scored. Keys with 9 points, and now the turnover. I think it's Valencia. Yeah, Romero was called for a travel. And you just feel like as Burdick comes back into the game for Carrera that it's no lead is safe for Valencia against this very talented Skio team. Oh, another errant pass, this time to get away with it because Casas wasn't able to catch it. Six on the shot clock, however. Astudu gets it to Verona, and Mabry puts it up. I mean, that is just quality. And from trailing by 11, the deficit is now just 3 points for Skio. All the momentum back with the team from Italy. Cox fakes, drives in, puts it up, and she scores, and she is fouled. Well, that is determination right there. LaManna comes back in for Valencia. Romero goes out. Salvador is also back in. Here's Cox, the former standout at Baylor. Bastogno is back in. Astudu goes out. So the three-point play, that was a very important bucket and sequence for Valencia to try to stem the flow of points from Skio. Need to stop the rot. And Salvadoris this time whistled for the foul. Burgos appealing for an elbow. Here, you be the judge. Oh boy, I think Ryan Howard really got away with one there. It looked like she threw her left arm into her and knocked Salvadoris over. But have to see the other angle. You gotta love the way that Valencia have been playing defense. And LaManna whistled for the personal. And that's a good call. Definitely reaching around and making contact. So two more fouls and Skio will be in the bonus. Mabry has it knocked out of her hands. And Valencia defensively has just really been disruptive. Salvadoris over to Cox. And the Baylor standout knocks it down. Just 24 years of age. She and Gulich and Carrera have been outstanding for Valencia. Here's Mabry. She dumps it down low to Bastogno. Doesn't get it off clean. Now the pass, ill-advised. And the foul, I think it's Salvadoris or LaManna. You want to get out and run. No, it was Casas. You want to get out and run, but you don't want to make the bad pass. It was LaManna with the foul, trying to get it back. So Buena Vida comes back in for Salvadores. Salvadores goes out. Oh, a 9-point advantage. Howard to Bastagno. Spins, turns, and the double team comes. Somebody's got to be open, and that somebody was Keys. Good job by Bastagno. Lamana, good hesitation, good bounce pass, good layup. What beautiful basketball by Valencia Basket, and Lamana really bringing it from the bench. You love to see the technical aspect to her game, her making that right decision on the bounce pass. And this Valencia team is well-schooled in their movement. Here's where they're getting punished down low, and Cox reaches in and commits the foul. Because they're going for so many double teams, it does create openings, does create some spots. And that time, well, it's just a good aggressive play by Keys going to the basket. Keys already with 11 points. Mabry goes out. Mestag comes back in. If you're Valencia Basket, you need to make sure that you're up by several points going into halftime. Skio trying to put on the pressure, and it creates an opening for Lamana. Almost turned it over. She looks a little shaky. She's able to get it to Burdick. Here goes Casas. Puts it up the left hand. Now Mestag. And they will hold it for one if Valencia allow them to. They're up seven. Verona steps back for three. Good! Oh, boy, that is a quality shot. And Verona has really developed into a great shooter at the end of shot clocks. They got a great shot. Valencia Basket did not. A little craziness by Casas, the Burgos' team. Valencia lead it 46-42 at halftime. Carrera with the 12 points, leading Valencia. Now Keys has a game-high 13. And you can see the other leaders in those respective categories. 14 and a half minutes before the start of the second half. 46-42, Valencia on top. And you can see Valencia with more rebounds. A couple more assists for Skio, which is a little surprising. And good shooting for the teams. So after a short break, we'll be right back before the start of the second half.
Y anem a actualitzar la agenda perquè torna el bàsquet en directe. El diumenge 10 a la 1, València Bàsquet, embutidos, Pacariel, Benvibre. I a les 10 també, a les 8, a les 6 de la vesprada, Covirán i Nana. A la 1, el 6 i a les 6, el Covirán i Nana, València Bàsquet. Nous partits així, a la Fonteta. Diumenge de la cremada, diumenge de Palles, a la una, Liga Femenina e Inglesa, y el que sigue la verdad, Liga Inglesa.
It's a dangerous game three for Schio if Valencia able to force it, remembering how well they played in game one, a game that was knotted with 5 minutes remaining before Schio pulled away. So will Valencia have enough fuel in the tank to make it to the end this time, or will Schio get the sweep and advance to the semifinals, i.e. the Final Four? Third quarter action underway here. Valencia starting with possession in this vital, vital game. They need to win to stay alive in the hope of getting to the Final Four. And Casas misses from deep. Not sure that's the shot they want. But the offensive rebound keeps the basketball at this end. Romero, Salvadores. Spins and it's good shot by Mari Gulić, who just continues to produce tonight. Outstanding effort. So the lead goes back to six. Remember, Constanza Verona hit the three right at the end of the first half. Keys gets in, misses. Great rebound from Carrera. Salvadores traveled. She was very herky-jerky in her movements that time, and it was just one herky-jerky too much. She turns it over. Here it is again. See? I think they got it right. Good job by the refs. Certainly looked awkward. Howard from deep, and that was real short. And Carrera picks up the rebound. The Howard, a player that Schio need to contribute. Oh, what a pass and what a finish. Beautiful basketball once again, and the finish by Carrera. 14 points, quite a contrast from game one for her. Satana. The double comes, as to do, not able to get the ball down low with Carrera getting, oh, look at the hands up on defense, forcing the turnover. They get it back. Did they ever get possession? And that's the question. Did Valencia have possession? They're going to talk about it, because if they did not, they will get the basketball. They had to have clear possession before the ball was stolen back. As you can see, they restarted the shot clock. Okay, so they say shot clock violation. They did not have possession. You could say that was a tough call. Let's see, does she have possession here? No. Yeah, she just never really picked it up. Even so, it is a tough call against Schio. Beautiful pass, and again the layup. Carrera making a living, catching those bounce passes and just going up for layups. They see the defense coming. They faced it in the first game. They were ready for it this time, and Valencia move up by 10 points.
Under the basket. Four. inside. And we are like this. Pass inside or pass here and inside. That moment, four, go outside. The moment that we get off, go outside. Five, stay here. Okay, let's go. One, two, three.
Well, once again, Valencia have pushed the lead back up to double digits, 52-42. And just have not allowed Skio to get comfortable on offense. Mabry back in the game. Keys, Howard, Astudu, and Satana. Time clock about to expire. They get it down low to Keys. Oh, what a finish from Keys, having just a terrific, terrific game. She did have a game where she scored 17 this season. Here they are passing it around. Romero for three. Right decision. And Romero just showing a lot of maturity right now. Very impressed by her performance after some struggles in her career. Satana gets it deep. Passes the keys. She's got the hot hand. Why not? But not able to knock it down this time. And Carrera not able to rebound with Astudu, putting the pressure on her. So they put 14 on the shot clock. Oh, Salvador is almost going the other way. Howard missing. And again, it's going to stay at this end as the ball bounces off the hands of Romero. Mabry. Over to Keys. Well, running out of superlatives here. She is just electric. You just have to applaud her, which is exactly what Burgos did. She's got 18 points, a season high. Salvador gets to the baseline, picks up her dribble. She left her feet not knowing what she was going to do with the basketball, and then Valencia commit the foul. When you leave your feet like that, you know you're either going to shoot it or you're going to pass it. You can't be indecisive. Trying to make something happen. I'm sure you got to give touches to Keys right now the way she's been shooting it. Here's Satana. Oh, nice little wraparound over to Astudu, but it's too long. And now Mabry called for going over the back. And to be fair, it looked like she went straight up. But definitely Casas had position. Look at this. I mean, oh no, have they called the foul on Casas? No, they did. They called it on Mabry. And to me, Mabry hasn't done anything wrong there. She just goes straight up. So maybe a break for Valencia. Could have been a no call, really. Shot clock to six. Romero, slick dribbling, and great defense from Howard, but then Howard commits. No, they call the foul. Have they called an unsportsmanlike? Thought they were going to call the foul on Howard there. Watch this. No, that was great defense, and that's just a normal foul. Good physical play from both players. Mabry goes behind the back, puts it up. I mean, she's just outstanding. For me, she's the best player out there. And you can see that she enjoys the moment. She enjoys trying to come back. She's not bothered by trailing by several points. She's comfortable out there. Quick pass to Carrera, who's tripped up by Astudu. So free throws coming for Carrera. And the crowd really getting into it with Astudu complaining. They're riding her now, asking for a technical foul. So Mabry goes out. It's a brave move. And Kim Mestag checks in. Trailed by as many as 11 points in the first half, Skio. They cut it to four at halftime, but right now Valencia have pushed the lead back up to 8 points. And just an amazing game, really, for Carrera tonight. Work it around. Ryan Howard decides to take the three, misses. The ball goes down to the feet of the Valencia center, Cox, and then it goes out of bounds off of Astudu, who says, "Are you sure?" Don't tell me this isn't a basketball city when you look at this crowd tonight. I mean, they have such incredible support for the women's and the men's teams. And it really does make a difference. As you can see tonight, they are giving this Skio team everything they can handle and more. And meanwhile, Turin's getting ready to come back in on the next dead ball. Cox to the corner, her pass over the outstretched hands of Salvadores. So Verona back in, hands it off to Mestag. Nice movement to get a layup for Du. Oh, she misses the layup. She stays with it, and Valencia come down with the basketball. What a break. Torrens there for the rebound. And now great D from Pena as Casas drives in. I mean, oftentimes you will see with that big swipe down the foul call, but it looked like she had all ball. Cox drills another one. Big time effort tonight for the home team. Under 4 minutes to go in the third quarter. There's Astudu fouled while shooting the three. She's got three free throws. Well, she came in shooting 75% from the line. Makes her first attempt of the night. Makes her second. And if she drops this one, it'll be all three. But she does not. And now a foul on Verona. A little unfortunate, the ball bounces over Verona. She reaches over, tries to tie up Casas. And she just kind of cut, she kind of clanged into her. Yeah. Easy call for the ref. Yes. Oh boy, that could be a dangerous pass. Romero. Guarded closely. Left open. She puts it up and misses it badly. And both Gulick and Cox in the game right now. Gulick commits the foul. Burdick comes back into the game and Gulick goes out. As she goes out with her third foul. Mestag from deep misses badly. And now overhead pass going to lead to a layup from Casas. Boy, that's a 5-point swing right there. And the lead goes to 10. Verona puts it up, and good move again by the point guard. And now some contact and a foul. So the foul called on the Lithuanian center, Svintoraitė. Yeah, the holds on Cox. Entry pass, Burdick. Boy, this is a well-schooled Valencia team. They have really done well. And there's Cox with another rebound. Nice pass to Burdick. Again, passes it back outside. Casas. And even though they didn't score, what just creating great opportunities with their passing game and movement. This time the drive from Verona, really been one of their best players tonight. Turin's shot clock about to expire. She's going to put, oh, look at the handling. She goes off one leg and it doesn't drop. Well, the game is definitely shortening Skio's opportunities. You know, at some point, Mabry is going to become a factor again. Right now, she's out of the game. And now she's checked back in. She's got three fouls, though. That's why the coach had her out. But he needs her in there making some plays. Torrens for three. Good! Boy, nothing like experience and quality. And that is what Torrens has in abundance. Even if she's not at 100%, she can still deliver. Mestag from deep, long rebound. Here's Mabry, and she is bumped by Casas. Well, the fans getting excited here. I think their team has a real chance to force a deciding third game. Here in the final minute of this third quarter, and Valencia leading by 11. Still, almost 11 minutes to go. That is a long time. Verona. Bestagno off the bench. Nope. Long rebound for the second consecutive time. Mabry has it. Gets down low. Doesn't drop. She follows the shot. Look at Cox go up for the rebound. The outlet pass to Torrens. And Torrens has it knocked out of her hands, but fortunately for Valencia, it goes to Cox. And I don't think Cox needs to take that shot. She should have passed it back out. She was pretty well guarded there. 4 second differential, the game clock and the shot clock. Verona's been good in these situations. She steps back. Nope. Yep. She's going to be open and she's going to make it. I mean, out of all the players you cannot leave open tonight with the shot clock winding down at the end of the quarter is that player right there. And they may have called an off the ball foul. Wow, they called a technical foul on Burdick for saying something after the shot. So that'll be a free throw. And then I think Valencia will get it back. But that is calling into question the emotional discipline of Burdick. I mean, you can't be up by this many points riding the referee and giving the other team a chance to cut into that deficit at the free throw line. Competitive juices are flowing, and sometimes it's hard not to say something, but you simply cannot help the opponent. So it does cost them. The referee, you never know. I mean, what the referee has been saying throughout the night. Final shot of the quarter. And that's how it finishes. So I guess they give up the 1 point of the technical, but it wasn't a disaster. Nevertheless, we'll see how that shapes up at the end of the game. But right now, Valencia on top. 66-59 against Beretta Famalesquio. 10 minutes remaining. Valencia's rebounding has really been good tonight. And look at that. They now have 4 more assists. So they 6 more assists than Schio in that third quarter. Keys and Carrera each with 18 points. Romero with 8 assists. Verona also leading her team in the assist department and also hitting a lot of big shots. And the three-point shooting has been excellent, really, for both teams. There's the Valencia basket owner, Roach. Loves basketball. And you can see the points by quarter. Now, go back to the game one. And that's when it all went horribly wrong for Valencia. Okay, they were outscored 20-7 in the fourth quarter. But remember, they're playing at home tonight. And perhaps the experience factor, perhaps having Torrens back in the lineup or available, perhaps having the crowd tonight helping them, that'll make the difference. Fourth quarter action underway here in La Fonteta. And it's Skio starting with possession. Astudu gets it, and she is fouled by Cox. Going for the block. So puts Du back on the court, back on the free throw line where she was 2 of 3 so far tonight. Remember, she was fouled attempting a three-pointer in the last quarter and made 2 of 3. Astu makes the first. And she gets both to go. Nice follow through. So the lead back to 5, and it's that uncomfortable margin here for Valencia that they've been able to push the lead back up. But you just wonder, one of these points, if Skier are going to get a stop and then go down and score and eventually take the lead. Shot clock winding down. Good drive, Romero. Oh, she just missed the layup. Did everything right but make the shot. Now the pass over to Howard. Back outside to Mabry. Her pass down low, and the ball goes off of Cox. So far, two good offensive sets have been run by this Skio team. And if you're going to leave anybody open, you would think it would be Bestagno. Here's Howard. Howard gets in, puts up kind of a wild shot with the left hand. Not what they needed. Needs to be a little stronger going to the basket. Now over to Buena Vida. You can count it. That's a big time shot. No hesitation whatsoever. And now the anticipation and almost a steal by Casas. She wanted to foul Mabry. She doesn't get it. Now Mabry launches it from deep, and she might have missed everything. Casas was appealing for a foul, but in the end, they just have to be careful, Valencia. They've already had one technical called on Burdick late in the third quarter. They don't want another one. They're up by several points. Casas dribbles right, gets into the paint. They spread it around. And the drive and tough shot. Good defense, and the ball goes off. Oh. Ball goes off of Buena Vida. Thought it might have gone off of Astudu. Watch this. Oh, no, that definitely went off of Buena Vida. Buena Vida, good life. Direct translation. Well, she'll be having a good life if they win tonight. Howard. And Buena Vida called for contact in the paint. Getting tangled up with Bestagno. Howard puts it up, and finally gets one to drop. It's a 2, so it's back to a 6-point game. Eight points for Howard. Carrera outside. She's just done it all, folks. She has been a superstar tonight. 20 points, 8 of 9 from the floor, inside the arc. Mabry. Oh, good help defense from Valencia. Then Cox goes over and picks up the loose ball. just a little stagnant offensively, surprisingly, for Schio. Cox, the long jumper. And Carrera goes up for the rebound, passes it back outside. Buena Vida, she misses it from deep. They stay with the basketball, the scramble. Howard comes up with it, over to Mabry. Oh, Mabry goes behind the back. What a move from Mabry. Her skill set is just off the charts. I mean, that was magical. Look at this, behind the back. Casas, now you see me, now you don't. And then it was Carrera reaching in and committing the foul. Burdick comes back into the game. Carrera picked up that foul. Here's Mabry again. And it's Verona. I mean, how clutch is Verona? How clutch is Verona? She has been sensational. 17 points. Now she has 20. And a lot of her shots coming at the end of the shot clock. Burdick keeps it away from Howard. Cox launches it from a long way out, misses everything. And just a little, well, good defense. Give the credit to Schio. Maybe a little bit too much dribbling by Burdick. Need to move the basketball. Big possession for Schio. Verona. Better get a hand in the face. They do. Now it's Keys. Better guard her. Shot clock winding down. She's going to launch it. No, she's going to dump it down low to Astu. Do it. She is fouled. Good decision by Verona. She would have been tempted to put it up, but instead, she did the right thing by feeding the low post and getting it to Astu Du. It is all hands on deck right now for both of these teams as Valencia call a timeout. So remember, as we look at the highlights, last week, it was right about this point when the wheels came off for Valencia, and Schio really turned up their game. We're going to have a repeat tonight. I guess the difference was with 5 minutes left, it was tied in game one. Right now, 5.5 minutes, and Valencia have a 71-66 lead. So that's to do a chance to cut the deficit to just 3 points. And makes the first. It is so difficult to close out games in the EuroLeague women. Astu only makes one of two, and the lead back to 4 points, right where we were at halftime. Salvadores over to Romero. She gets blocked, but Cox steps over, and she draws the foul. Well, Cox alertly. Excuse me, that's Gulich, who's checked back in. She picked up the ball, and then just a break as the foul was called, I believe, on Verona. He was indeed. Valencia fans watching nervously. And Gulich misses the first. Takes her time and makes the second. She came in having hit 72% of her free throws, 8 of 11. So not really too many attempts. And the dump and the block. Terrific recovery from Marie Gulich. Good play run by Skia, just not able to get past Gulich, the Germany international, who we're going to see at the FIBA Women's Eurobasket this summer. Here we are. She launches off the back of the iron, and good work by Howard, knocking it out of the hands of Burdick. Now on the break, Mabry! That was long, but the ball fell right off the backboard to Howard, and then her pass intended for Mabry. But it was right at her feet, and I'm not sure that Mabry knew that it was coming. Romero. And good hands right at the end, almost coming up with the steal again. Salvadoris, shot clock down to 5. Salvadoris steps to the left and drains a three-pointer. Boy, that was big time. The lead back to 7, 4 minutes to go. Carrera defends. Salvadoris goes out. Now Verona. Verona into Astudu, and she gets rejected again. Gulich has played tremendous defense here in this last couple of possessions. Unusual to see Astudu get rejected twice, but Gulich just turned into a swat machine. Carrera, nice turn and bumped by Adu, no call. Romero, tough pass, great catch, Burdick. Burdick gets it up just in time. She follows. What an effort by Burdick. What an effort. She did so well to make the catch. And then she had to get her balance, knowing the clock was about to expire. And she makes the shot to stretch the lead back to 9. Well, you wanted fireworks in Valencia tonight. You've got them. They're having their own little Las Fallas inside La Fonteta. Crowd has really made a difference tonight. They have been backing this Valencia basket effort. They want to make this as tough as possible on Skio. The stakes are oh so high trying to get to the Final Four. And you see how much it means to these fans. Even the kids have come out tonight. 9 points, the advantage. Santana, back in the game, puts it up from deep. Oh, I mean, are you kidding me? That is ice running in her veins, coming right out of the timeout, not wasting any time. And that shot just gave them a little bit more hope. But now Mabry reaches in, commits the foul. It's number 4.
Okay.
Three-pointer from Salvador. Oh, it falls kindly. What a break to Gulick. She tries to pass it, and now it's going to lead to a break. And up it goes, and Mabry lays it up and in. And now it's a four-point game, and Salvador did not need to take the shot so quickly. And then Valencia just needed to rebound the basketball and pass it back out, but instead they trigger a break, and suddenly it's a four-point lead. Salvador is able to hit that three-pointer, but on that last possession, she was wide open. I suppose just felt like it was a good opportunity. Great defense, but again, it is so difficult to close out these games. And you look back, no shot has been bigger tonight for Skio than what we just saw from Satana. Just come right off the bench and nail a three-pointer with hardly any time coming off the clock. Look at that, right there. Can Valencia hold on? What are they going to run? We could hear their coach giving very clear instructions. And they tried to get it to Carrera. This time they were ready for it. The hands were up on defense. And now almost coming up with a steal was Casas. Satana, she just hit that 1-3. She can look for another one. Nope, she passes to Keys. And Keys turns it over. Casas, they don't have to rush. And that was the right decision. Casas, again, she drives in. And good defense this time. Mabry, Casas looks at the referee. Mabry living dangerously. She's got the four fouls. And I guess the referee is saying the hand is part of the ball. Great patience by the referee, I have to say. That's good refereeing. Good officiating. Carrera turns, puts it up, doesn't get it. Look at that tremendous rebound by Romero. But they may have called the foul before, which will send Carrera to the line. I think it was on Satana. And that's why you have to rebound as a team. You know, Romero, not just with her and her shooting and her dribbling, she actually gets in there and crashes the boards. And indeed, they called the foul on Satana. Salvadores. Shot clock about to expire. She needs to put it up. She does. Misses. And this time, it's a four-point deficit. Here comes Mabry again. She thought about it. Bounce pass over to Bastagno. Mabry for three. You can count it. Unreal. At no point does Skio think they're going to lose this game. And Mabry is the perfect player in this situation. Because Valencia really wishing she would have fouled out on that last trip down. And now the nerves are really going to settle in. Valencia, though, they can't mess around. They've got to get a good shot off. And Romero puts it up. And now Mabry has it. And the defense from Skio has won the last two possessions. They can take the lead. Plenty of shot makers on the floor for Skio. Here's one of them, Mabry. She wants to take it. You can see it. This is what she lives for. This is what she's worked for. She puts it up. The defense wins for Valencia. Terrific effort from the Taronja. But another huge possession. Skio do not want to foul here. About a 12-second difference on the game clock and the shot clock. Romero over to Cox. And Cox, a little bit of love from the rim. Can you believe it? The basketball gods siding with Valencia here in the crucial stage. Ball bounced high off the rim and came back down. What a sequence. What a sequence for Lauren Cox and Valencia. Mabry ticked off. She wasn't able to score on that previous trip. But whether they like it or not, they might have to end up playing a deciding game three unless they can conjure up some magic here, trailing by four. If you're Valencia, you definitely don't want to foul the three-point shooter because it could be a potential four-point play. I think if I'm Skio, I can try to get a quick two and then foul. Get a steal or foul. And that was the three that pulled them to within one. And then that's where she thought she had drawn the charge. They did not call it. And the referee looked over at her and said, get up. Cox has gone out. Burdick is in. Pistogno has gone out. Kim Mestag has come in. Mestag inbounding the basketball. She gets it to Howard. Mabry for three. Misses. Valencia rebounded. It's Carrera. And she is fouled. And with 10.3 seconds left, the chances are drying up here for Skio. And it's all about this fan support tonight for Valencia. They have been amazing. You just can't make it up, folks. And they're now going to see if it's an unsportsmanlike foul that sent Carrera tumbling to the ground. Mabry takes the three. Well, it looked like they're reaching, and they hadn't called the foul, and maybe Howard gave a little nudge there at the end, which they could call the unsportsmanlike, but we'll see. I don't know what they're going to call. I didn't see enough. Nope, normal foul. If there's not enough evidence, you can't make the unsportsmanlike foul. But they did a good job by reviewing it. So 10.3 seconds left. And if you are surely Skio, you got to commit the quick foul. You don't get to steal, you foul. Then you go down and try three if Valencia push it up to a six-point lead. If they don't, I wasn't thinking that they needed a three on that one. I thought they could have got something going to the basket. And cut the deficit to two, but instead they elected to go for the three because they had 15 seconds. Cox's shot was huge, to put it mildly. Had a friendly bounce, fell through for a three-pointer. Just missed Egg Howard, Satana, Keys, and Astudu in the game. Was on Keys at the other end. So they advance the ball. In fact, no, they did not advance the ball. So 1.3 seconds goes off the clock. And Carrera at the line. You saw she has a double-double tonight. And she was 4-5. Now she's 4-6 from the free throw line. She makes the second. 21 points, 11 rebounds, 3 steals, 2 blocks. Plus 32 efficiency. That is a good night's work. Verona, another three attempt, this time off the rim. And Valencia start to celebrate. They have forced the deciding third game. They live to fight another day. And they have given this crowd a wild ride tonight. I can only assume that George Dikoulakis was saying that Mabry had been fouled before the three-pointer that was made, but this just sets up a really tasty game three. Valencia win it 80-75 over Beretta Famalesquillo. The rebounding difference was huge tonight. Five more assists as well. And game three will now be played on Wednesday. And look at the hugs for Carrera. 21 points, 11 rebounds. Romero is outstanding with the 10 assists. Cox was big. Everybody was big tonight for Valencia basket. And you couldn't have asked for much more, really, from Costanza. Excuse me, from Verona, nor from Keys. You could pick any number of these players to be the MVP tonight. I mean, they were just so good as a team. Gulich and Cox just outstanding, making huge plays for both of them. You know, how incredible was it that Satana had not scored when she came into the game late in the clutch and hit a three-pointer? That was for Schio. Howard, I think, had an off night from her normal self. Keys was terrific, 18 points, 6 rebounds. Astudu struggled tonight, just 1 of 8 from the floor, 3 rebounds. She did make 5 of 7, and Kim Mestag just played just under 13 minutes, 1 of 5 from the floor. So Mabry, 12 points, 7 rebounds, 7 assists. So again, there are the final numbers, 15 turnovers apiece. Valencia scoring 20 points off the turnovers, 15 for Schio. Second chance points, 10 for Valencia. points in the paint. Valencia really made the commitment. So again, Sopran's title defense is over as Fenerbahce eliminate them in two games. It has been a lot of fun tonight, folks. Thanks for watching here from Valencia, who forced the decider. They win it 80-75.